It's one of the most unique labs in the United States, really in the world. It's, so far as I know, it's the largest industrially enabled CNC design lab, right? Not in a mechanical engineering department, not in an aerospace department, but in an architecture and industrial design department. And what it does is it gives us an opportunity to allow students to really test ideas. That's the most important thing. So what design students, be it architects or industrial design, what they're constantly doing is this sort of wonderful creative work where they're coming up with new ideas, they're making drawings and representations of those ideas, but they don't really get to test the validity of those ideas. A scientist would write the hypothesis and then do 10 experiments, right? Take the results, codify those results, publish those results. And we're able to do something very similar in the design and construction industry. So a design student can have an idea and can actually test that idea through material making. And one project that we're sort of wrapping up right now, which I think is a great example of that, is the Simple Boss project. This is a GTRI project. It's a very large Department of Energy funded project where this lab has served as a fundamental infrastructure for the creative work that has happened in that project. And our charge was to develop new structures for solar panels that are much cheaper, much lighter, much faster to install in order to change the game. And that entire project could not have happened without this lab as a physical and intellectual space for all of those people to come together to develop new ideas and to test new ideas.